All right, yins guys, I'm gonna do another video. The last one I did, I kind of ran out of data space on this camera because I had other stuff in the camera and I just cut it short. I do talk about with or without the gloves on my particular clubbells, and it's like, I'm gonna show you here. These, notice I can also stand them up like that, just like other clubbells, But like, yeah, one of these guys that actually followed me, yeah, I got these. I used to work at a scrap yard, and I recommend you watch and use improvised items like this. If you work at a scrap yard or if you go to a scrap yard and sell scrap, if you can ask people to buy certain things, or if you have a work at a place where you have access to even pieces of cold roll bar, don't go stealing the shit, okay? If you work somewhere, I mean, there's sometimes if certain pieces are scrap, if you do work somewhere, you know, you could ask and see if they will sell you it, you know, I mean, and get it right. You know, don't lose your job, don't go be stealing or anything like that. But see, with this here too, I found this kind of tape. I actually found this tape for free. Instead of using gloves, you may want to use this too on one of them, but my thing, I can use this as a baton and or club bell. We'll go lighter or heavier. I mean, I advocate using smaller items. But any of you guys that followed my videos, I recommend taking the weightlifting bars, the 45-pound weightlifting bar, or the ones that are slightly lighter. Saw them in half, or get somebody to burn them in half with a torch for you. Use those as club bells. But yeah, I still have it in some of my videos in my archives, but so to speak. But where I was continuing before, I was telling you guys, you know, in the last video, do as much as this as possible, you know, to get more control and hold it. I mean, do sessions of just holding it, like for like a bunch of minutes or a longer time, or even if you're listening to music, a length of a whole song, you're holding both. And then be able to do this. The more of this you be able to do, the better, because it avoids, you can do everything else more gracefully. What I like about these, you could, unlike actually the club bells that you see everybody else in YouTube using, you can stand them up if you want to, but don't knock them over. But I like to lay them down and pick them up like a baton. I want to be able to do both. But yeah, the more of that you do, the better. Like, you get more control and be able to like hold it. And then I do this, you can do this with or without gloves. I want to tell you a little bit too. You guys that follow my videos, I have two of these. These are steel, you got to keep them kind of cleaned off so they don't rust and shit. But the other two I got are made out of, I don't know if it's titanium or stainless or something, but it's not aluminum, because aluminum you can, even that heavy treated aluminum, the size of those ones I got, they kind of have some kind of brass or gold plate to them or something. And I don't know where the hell those come from, but I bought them when I worked at a scrapyard. But they do not pick up with a magnet, and if you hit both of them together, I think I've seen that on one of my videos. Ding! Like, so it's probably stainless, because you know it's heavier than aluminum, and that definitely ain't no aluminum. I think I did a video where I had all four of these clubs on the dolly, two of these and two of the other ones. But anyway, get on with the jibber jabber. After you're able to do plenty of this, then you can graduate to do this. And as much as this is possible, but you've got to be able to do plenty of this. The more of this, the better. And then with mine, unlike the other clubs, you can eventually grab it further on the end, you know, and then you feel that forearm flexing. But like with this, if you're not ready to go grab it further in the end of the grip, you can go like this first. I think in my earlier videos, I've done that, see, with this. But unlike, because I wanted to make a homemade, either molded out of something or wood, make the zircon A clubs. What I like about them, they're big and wide, and when you see them zircon A people, the Persian club bell, those are fatter than the American club bell. I think we should make our own design for them. when you're using the club, since they're wider. Well, if you guys took a water jug of that bottled water, like you guys have at work, the wide, like whatever water you have, that it's gonna be like this wide and shit. So if there's some room to grip, if you go that, hold that on your shoulder and do that with a water jug. But they also call that Indian club, but I actually had some idea if you had any Native American in you, or if you were into Native American stuff, you might want to make your own wooden Zircone club and call it an Indian club and put Indian designs on it. Because unlike American, other things like American club bell, like I see people do, the other ones, like you buy them in a weightlifting store, you know what I mean? They have a round ball on the end of them, and you see people going, spreading their legs, and I don't care for people like jerking their backs around all the time doing that with that kettlebell. They're doing it with clubbell. They're jerking the back. I think you should have, all right, like the jazz song, it don't mean a thing if you ain't got that swing. But instead of jerking your back around, kind of do a little bit of graceful swing. Just go like this. Don't smack yourself in the groin. That's what I also don't like about that. But like a little swing like this first, and then you could just gracefully bring it up and down. Like if it's, I have to put the camera down to show you, but that's why I kind of like, say you want a club bell and a baton and both. And then I say like for some of the, if you follow like the Persian exercise like some YouTubers are doing, they also have a thing called a press up board or bar in their ritualistic exercise. And I put this on the floor and do push-ups on it. And kind of do like what the Persians are doing with the push press-up board. But only my thing also is the press-up board. And I'll even do knuckle push-ups and go right against with my fist, you know, right on the cement. Like, I have to do another video with this camera lower, so I don't always have a camera person. You know what I mean? The last place I used to work, yeah, I was bribing some of my coworkers with money and gifts or giving things that I don't use anymore because I got something else, and then as an incentive and a hint, look the other way on some stuff I'm doing too and shit like that. So. But I never liked that job that much anyway, and I was looking for better, but I knew it was going down eventually, but I didn't expect it to happen as soon as I did. I thought I had a little bit more leeway, so to speak. But anyway, like that's pretty much how you do it. Then if you wanted to use gloves so you don't lose your grip or whatever, use these. Place I used to work, we had all kind of these, but in my case, I didn't get these from there. Trucks going all over the road, I find these on the road, but I had a good black pair of these that I bought. But when I lost all my belongings, when I left my old home, they got thrown away, so to speak. But yeah, you can get gloves like this for free, get them, you know. But in that case, you could hold them way more like this and have a better grip and a little more leverage too. And you can, and like that, and like that. Then eventually you can do this. Hold the hand with the palm back. Stretch that shit out a little bit. Like that. And like that. Make sure I'm in the camera. I have to turn around and make sure I'm in the camera. And you can go a little rapidly. It's okay if you want to go smack yourself in the butt with the end of them a little bit. Go ahead, smack yourself in the butt with it. Ow. Ew. Or you could just go like this, hold it there for a minute, and then drag it up. Even if you've got to drag it close to your shoulder. You can even lean back a little bit, try to stretch that arm back. So if you want to stretch your arm for a back way. But like I said, I'll even review the one thing real quick. If you want to stretch for a back bend or stretch the back of your arms. But do as much as this as possible. Because the mind thing is designed to replace all those fancy ass, say if you don't, you can't afford to buy clubbells at a weightlifting store, you can get in a scrapyard. A lot of people are scrapping 45-pound weightlifting bars, which is good news for some of you guys who still like your bench pressing a huge amount of pounds. Some scrapyards, you can get it kind of cheaper. Well, in some cases, some scrapyards know what they're worth and all that, and they'll charge you a little bit more than really they should be charging you. But yeah, I saw your weightlifting bars in half. I was in on some of my old videos. But anyway, like, yeah, get the club. If you don't get the clubbell in the weightlifting store, I recommend you, if you can buy the clubbells in a weightlifting store, different sizes, or if you can't afford them, there's always some kind of way that you can get shit like this. Use about 3 or 4 crowbars in each hand, pry bars, different kind of. Because if you work with tools like I, the kind of line of work that I was always in, and a line of work that I prefer too. Different kind of things where you're carrying tools around, you know, this is going to benefit you, you know what I mean? And I, what I'm trying to advocate real quick here too, before I have a brain fart and forget one of the things I'm saying. I hate when I do that. I'm in the middle of a video, one of the main things I want to say. My main point, I should make a separate video and say this and not anything else and just call it what my main point is. But my main point, if you got this far in a video, if any of you faithful viewers got this far in this video, the main point is whether you do this or the clubbells in the weightlifting store, that is better than some damn cable pull machines that maybe you buy them yourself or you're making payments on it. And well, some of you people could prefer, if you can afford that shit, and if you got plenty of room for that shit, you know, I mean, my brother wanted to give me one of those for free, and I'd have to find somebody to haul it. And another thing, I don't believe him. I'm a firm believer. You don't need that kind of shit, and you don't need the conformist type of gym where everybody wears those certain kind of clothes, and there's a designated way to work out. Everybody's men and women are. It's almost a conformist type of thing. You're training for other things, you know what I mean, too, that are none of reasons that are none of people's fucking business. But shit like this is better than those cable pull machines because you've got more freedom. But yeah, the cable pull machines are like better than a lot of your other kind of weights. But Chuck Norris's Total Gym, I recommend that. It's because Chuck Norris is cool, and he did a smart thing where if you don't have all that room and all that for that shit, that it's meant to replace all that. And that's kind of a nice thing there, too. But this, you've got more freedom. You can set them in the closet. I mean, I got like 4 of these and saw your weightlifting bars in half. I get a couple of those again. I don't have those anymore because when I left my old address, that's going to be 2 years ago. Some of you people that know me know what went down there. I lost a lot of my shit. So someday I'll go back and check a scrapyard, you know, and I'll go and get a couple more of those weightlifting bars and have them sawn in half again. And I'll own them again and maybe purchase some of these other pry bars and tools. That's my next goal. Eventually try to get more of those kind of equipment there for you there to show you guys. But as of now, I still got my videos in my archives to show you, but that's eventually gonna change, you know what I mean? But I think I'll stop this video right here. It's going on like gonna be 15 minutes already. But yeah, you got the basic idea. You can use gloves and anyway, with these, if you want to go like
heavier version of the baton or a clubbell, that's your advantage. That's what I'm saying. But, all right.